When you are creating your YouTube video or uploading the finished product, it could be really helpful to have some insider tips. It can be your title, your description, tags, or even the idea itself, or the full script. This is where vidIQ comes in. It's a super powerful tool that can guide you in the right direction for your next video. First, I need to say that vidIQ is not sponsoring this video. They don't even know who I am. And everything in this video is my personal opinion of many years of using their software, both free and the paid tools. If this is your first time hearing about vidIQ, let me quickly explain. vidIQ is a browser extension that you install and give permission to access your YouTube and your YouTube channel. Then it will give you suggestions on how you can improve your channel and your videos. They also have a helpful YouTube channel with tips and various YouTube related topics to help you on your YouTube journey. Plus, they have the vidIQ website and the vidIQ app. I'll show you the cool features you get for free and what you can expect if you decide to pay for the full thing. Just to clarify, this is not one of those 14-day free trial things where after the deal, everything suddenly changes and you need to pay and No, with vidIQ, the free version, you can use it for years. I've been using the free version for years myself. There are many tools that you can use for your next video. If you look over here on the left-hand side, you have daily ideas and it will open up the website. And as you can see, it will give me a bunch of ideas based on my YouTube channel. And the only difference between the paid and the free version of this site is that I will have access to a bunch of ideas, but you, sadly, if you have the free version, you will only have access to a few every single day. So in this first tab today, it will just show me an overview of everything on my channel, some keywords that I can use if I really wanted to use meme, for example. This is a paid thing. This is an AI that I can type in whatever I want to, and it will generate scripts and descriptions and everything. And then you have the create tab. I haven't really looked into it. I think it will generate thumbnails and stuff, and you can mess around with a bunch of stuff. And then we have the optimize tab. If I click on this one, it will just give me a bunch of scores. And if I change something in here, for example, my thumbnail or my details, I can click publish if I do the changes, and it will actually be connected to my YouTube and it will actually update on my YouTube. And then we have the keywords. This is the one that I suggest you guys to check out. This one is free and I think it will always be free. You can just type something in. Let's say I type in YouTube again, and it will show me a pretty like speedometer, and it will give me a score from 1 to I believe 100. Ideally, you want the number to be over 60 to have a chance in a saturated topic. So if I, for example, search bake cake, I have done this video before, search, it will give me a score of 30. It's really bad. You can see it's a medium search volume and a high competition. And this part right here is really helpful. If you just understand it and take a look at it, you will quickly understand, okay, this number, the first one needs to be as high as possible. This arrow needs to be on the green side. And both of these, if they are also green, that will help. But if we try something else, so if we try how to bake a chocolate cake, that one was just a little bit better. And I can click on the questions and it will give me a bunch of questions in the same niche. As you can see, this one right here is over 60. So this one is really good. This has a medium search volume and a low competition. And that one is really important because you want your video to stick out. The video that you are watching right now was because of this tool right here. Basically, what happened was I really wanted to try out the full version the other day, so I paid for it and I just messing around and I was typing in vidIQ, boom, and you can see it's a 56, and I was like, okay, what happens if I click on the questions tab? Oh, there are a bunch of green numbers. Okay, how to use vidIQ for YouTube videos. And this is the video that you are watching right now. So this tool is on the free version. It's super awesome and it's super helpful, and it's probably easier for you in your niche to search whatever that fits in your niche. So go ahead and go into vidIQ and get the thing and search right away. And you can see that by only tweaking the question or the title in this case, and you can sort of figure out, okay, will this work for my video or do I need to change the video altogether? This AI is specifically worked on YouTube and has learned a bunch about YouTube, and the vidIQ team has actually spent a lot of hours on making sure that this AI is for YouTube. Of course, you can use other AIs to make scripts and descriptions and titles also, but they will not be connected to your YouTube channel, so they can't really tell if you have done a good job in the past and if the new script helped. So I can go ahead and click write a YouTube community post, and you just paste in whatever niche you are in and it will just generate everything. And just look at this, it's super cool. And then we have the comparisons tab and the SEO tab. This one is only for the pro subscription, but it's pretty easy. I just click on my YouTube short. I don't really care about those anymore. And I can just add a bunch of tags, and vidIQ can help me out with my search engine optimization. And then you have this learn tab and different events that vidIQ are putting together. Over to the YouTube part, the extension has a bunch of stuff built in, like it can generate a bunch of titles, and it will just load for a while and it will understand all of this stuff. And I can just click and it will just insert the titles right here. It also gives me the same thing for my description, and it can help me with my tags. But if you are on the free version, you can only generate so many titles and descriptions before it tells you to wait until the next month, I think. This one right here is super awesome, and this one is on the free version as well. It's just simply a checklist, so you remember to do all of this stuff so you don't forget about anything, but to have at least a card and an end screen and use like the different stuff that YouTube provides you to understand what your video is about. Let's say subtitles. YouTube will take your subtitles and understand what is your video about from the subtitles. So that's pretty important to do. This one over here is a vidIQ score. It will basically just show you that you have used all of your tags and your keywords and stuff like that. And yeah, basically vidIQ is just a helping hand. And like I said before, we have all of this different stuff, different tools. There you have it, the vidIQ extension and the website. Again, the AI and everything else that vidIQ has is just suggestions to point you in the right direction. So don't expect vidIQ to be a magic genie that you can just activate and it will just boost your channel. No, this is simply a helping hand with years of YouTube experience and knowledge, and a good team that has put this all together for you. If you are still a bit unsure of the best strategy for your video and how you can optimize for your SEO, check out this video right here. Links for vidIQ and their extension will be in the description and their YouTube channel. Remember to subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Espeon, peace out, bye bye, goodbye.